हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सिंपल मैथ्स टेक्निक्स। ई चैनल मेरो फर्स्ट टाइम చూస్తున్నట్లయితే ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ టు మై ఛానల్।
ద ఫస్ట్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఇస్ ఎవాల్యుయేట్ ఇంటిగ్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ 1/2x + 1 హోల్ పవర్ 5 dx। సో హియర్ ఫస్ట్ మెథడ్ దట్ ఇస్ సబ్స్టిట్యూషన్ మెథడ్। హియర్ we assume that 2x plus 1 equals to t, so let 2x plus 1 equals to t, then differentiate on both sides। we differentiate 2x, that is 2 into, we differentiate x, that is dx, plus we differentiate 1, the value of 1 is 0, then that is equals to, we differentiate t, that is dt। so here 2dx is equals to dt। now dx is equals to 1/2 into dt। so here the value of integration of 1/2x plus 1 whole power 5 into dx can be written as integration of 1/2x plus 1 value, we substitute it as t, you can write it as t power 5 into dx value, we can write 1/2 into dt। so that is equals to 1/2 into integration of 1/t^5 dt। so 1/2 into integration of 1/t^5, we can write it as t^-5 into dt, that is equals to 1/2 into integration of t^-5 dt। it looks like the formula integration of x^n dx is equals to x^n+1/n+1। so using that formula, you can write it as t^-5+1/-5+1 plus c, so that is equals to 1/2 into t^-4/-4 plus c। so 1/2 into 1/-4, that is -1/h into t^-4, you can write it as t^4, 1/t^4 plus c, that is equals to -1/8 into t^4 plus c। now we substitute t value in above, so that we get -1/8 into 2x plus 1 whole power 4 plus c। so this is the solution of the given problem, and we discuss the second method of this problem using the direct method, that is here we can apply the direct formula of the given problem। so given that integration of 1/2x plus 1 whole power 5 into dx, so that is equals to, you can write it as 2x plus 1 whole power -5 into dx। so here it is same as the formula integration of ax plus b whole power n into dx, that is equals to 1/a into ax plus b whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1। using that formula, you can write 1/a, so 1/, here a value is 2, so 1/2 into ax plus b, that is 2x plus 1 whole power -5 plus 1 by -5 plus 1 plus c, so 1/2 into 2x plus 1 whole power -5 plus 1, that is -4 by -4 plus c, so 1/2 into 1/-4, that is -1/8 into 2x plus 1 whole power -4 plus c। so now you can write it as minus of 1/8 into 2x plus 1 whole power 4 plus c, so this is the solution of the given problem।
The next problem, evaluate integration of cosecant square of 4-7x dx। here first method,
let 4 minus 7x equals to t. So differentiate 4 minus 7x. Differentiate 4, we get 0. Then differentiate minus 7x, we get minus 7 into dx, that equals to differentiate t, that is dt. Now here dx equals to take minus 7 to this side, it becomes minus 1 by 7 into dt. Now the given problem is integration of cosecant square of 4 minus 7x into dx. Substitute the above values, then we get cosecant square of 4 minus 7x is t, and dx value is minus 1 by 7 into dt, that is equals to integration of cosecant square t into minus 1 by 7 into dt. Here minus 1 by 7 is constant value, then minus 1 by 7 into integration of cosecant square t dt. So minus 1 by 7 into integration of cosecant square t dt value is minus cot t plus c, that is equals to minus into minus plus. So cot t by 7 plus c. So we substitute t value, then we get cot of 4 minus 7x by 7 plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem. And also we discuss the second method. The second method is, so given that integration of cosecant square of 4 minus 7x into dx, so here it is same as the formula, integration of cosecant square of ax plus b into dx, that is minus cot of ax plus b by a. So using that formula, you can write minus cot of 4 minus 7x by a. A value is here minus 7. So minus minus cancel, remaining we get cot of 4 minus 7x by 7 plus c. This is the solution of the given problem. The next problem, evaluate integration of e power 3 minus 5x dx. The solution is, first method, let 3 minus 5x equals to t. We differentiate both sides. We differentiate 3, we will get 0. Then we differentiate minus 5x, that is minus 5 dx, that is equals to, we differentiate t dt. Then dx is equals to minus 1 by 5 into dt. So given that integration of e power 3 minus 5x into dx, that is equals to integration of e power, we replace 3 minus 5x as t, and we write dx as minus 1 by 5 into dt. So minus 1 by 5 is constant, then minus 1 by 5 into integration of e power t dt. So minus 1 by 5 into integration of e power t dt value e power t plus c. So minus 1 by 5 into, we substitute t value, we get e power 3 minus 5x plus c. This is the solution of the given problem. The second method, given that integration of e power 3 minus 5x into dx, here we use the formula integration of e power ax plus b into dx, that is 1 by a into e power ax plus b plus c. So here you can write 1 by a. Here a value is minus 5 because x coefficient is minus 5. So 1 by minus 5 into e power 3 minus 5x plus c. So that is minus 1 by 5 into e power 3 minus 5x plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem.
The next problem, evaluate integration of sine square 3x dx. So given that integration of sine square 3x dx, there is no direct formula of integration of sine square 3x dx or sine square x dx.
So you can write sine square x value as 1 minus cos 2x by 2. So using that formula, you can write sine square 3x as 1 minus cos 2 into here x, instead of x we have 3x, so we write 2 into 3x by 2 dx. That is equals to 1 by 2 into integration of 1 minus cos 2 into 3x, that is cos 6x dx. So 1 by 2 into, in separate the integration of 1 dx minus integration of cos 6x dx. So 1 by 2 into integration of 1 dx value x minus integration of cos 6x dx. So here it is same as the formula integration of cos x dx. Integration of cos x dx is sin x. So here integration of cos 6x dx value is sin 6x by, here the x coefficient is 6, we write the x coefficient value in the denominator, then we get sin 6x by 6 plus c. This is the solution of the given problem. The next problem, evaluate integration of cos square 4x dx. Solution is, that is equals to integration of cos square 4x dx. Here we know the formula cos square a, that is equals to 1 plus cos 2a by 2. That equals to, you can write cos square 4x value using this formula, 1 plus cos 2 into, instead of a we have 4x, that is you can write 1 plus cos 2 into 4x by 2 into dx. So 1 by 2 value into 1 plus cos 2 into 4x, that is 8x into dx. So now you can separate the integration, 1 by 2 into integration of 1 dx plus integration of cos 8x dx. 1 by 2 into integration of 1 dx, that is x, plus integration of cos 8x dx. Integration of cos x dx value is sin x. Integration of cos 8x dx value is sin 8x, but x coefficient is 8, so you can write by 8 plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem. The sixth problem is, evaluate integration of 2x minus 3 whole power 8 into dx. So the solution is, first method, this is substitution method. Here let 2x minus 3 equals to t, then differentiate on both sides, 2 into differentiate x, that is dx, that is equals to, we differentiate t, that is dt. So dx is equals to 1 by 2 dt. So given that integration of 2x minus 3 whole power 8 into dx, so we substitute the above values, 2x minus 3, that is t power 8 into dx value, that is 1 by 2 dt. So here 1 by 2 is constant. Now 1 by 2 into t power 8 into dt. So 1 by 2 into integration of t power 8 dt, that is t power 8 plus 1, 9 by 8 plus 1, that is 9 plus c. Using the formula integration of exponent dx, that is equals to exponent n plus 1 by n plus 1. So now that is equals to 1 by 2 into t power 9 by 9. So t power 9 by 9 2s are 18 plus c. Now we substitute t value, that is 2x minus 3 whole power 9 by 18 plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem. The second method is direct method. So given that integration of 2x minus 3 whole power 8 into dx, so here the formula integration of ax plus b whole power n into dx, that is 1 by a into ax plus b whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Using that formula, 1 by a, 1 by a, that is 1 by 2 into 2x minus 3 whole power 8 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 plus c. So here 1 by 2 into 2x minus 3 whole power 9 by 9 plus c. So 1 by 2 into 1 by 9, that is 1 by 18 into 2x minus 3 whole power 9 plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem. The next problem, evaluate integration of secant square of 2x plus 3 dx. So first method, that equals to integration of secant square of 2x plus 3 into dx. Let 2x plus 3 is equals to t, then differentiate on both sides, we get 2dx is equals to dt, then dx is equals to 1 by 2 dt. So here we substitute these values in above, we get secant square t into 1 by 2 dt. So 1 by 2 into integration of secant square t dt. So 1 by 2 into, we know that integration of secant square x dx value tan x. So here integration of secant square t dt value tan t plus c. Now substitute t value in above, we get 1 by 2 into tan of 2x plus 3 plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem. And we discuss the second method. So given that integration of secant square of 2x plus 3 into dx, so here we are using the formula integration of secant square of ax plus b into dx is equals to 1 by a into tan of ax plus b. So here 1 by 2 into tan of 2x plus 3 plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem. The next problem, evaluate integration of 1 by 1 minus 8x dx. The solution is, first method, let 1 minus 8x is equals to t, differentiate on both sides, we get minus 8 dx is equals to dt, then dx equals to minus 1 by 8 into dt. That is equals to integration of 1 by 1 minus 8x dx. Here we substitute the above values, integration of 1 by 1 minus 8x value t into dx value is minus 1 by 8 into dt. So integral minus 1 by 8 is constant value into integration of 1 by t dt, that is equals to minus 1 by 8 into integration of 1 by t dt value is log t plus c. So substitute t value minus 1 by 8 into log of 1 minus 8x plus c. Second method, the direct method, does equals to, given that integration of 1 by 1 minus 8x into dx, here we know the formula, integration of 1 by ax plus b into dx is equals to 1 by a into log of ax plus b. So 1 by a, here x coefficient is minus 8 into log of 1 minus 8x. So minus 1 by 8 into log of 1 minus 8x plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem. The next problem, evaluate integration of 1 by square root of 3 minus 2x dx. So the solution is, given that integration of 1 by square root of 3 minus 2x dx. So integration of 1 by square root of 3 minus 2x dx can be written in exponential form. You can write it as 3 minus 2x whole power 1 by 2 into dx. So integration of 1 by 3 minus 2x whole power 1 by 2, you can write it as 3 minus 2x whole power minus 1 by 2 into dx. So using the formula, integration of ax plus b whole power an dx, you can write 1 by a into ax plus b whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. So using that formula, integration of 3 minus 2x whole power 1 minus 1 by 2 dx, you can write it as 1 by a. So here x coefficient is minus 2. So 1 by minus 2 into 3 minus 2x whole power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by minus 1 by 2 plus 1 plus c. So here 1 by minus 2, that is minus 1 by 2 into 3 minus 2x, take LCM, LCM is 2, minus 1 plus 2, 1 is 2, by, here also we take LCM, minus 1 plus 2, 1 is 2, plus C. So minus 1 by 2 into 3 minus 2x whole power minus 1 plus 2, that is 1 by 2 by 1 by 2 plus C. So 1 by 2, 1 by 2 cancel, remaining minus of 3 minus 2x whole power 1 by 2 plus c. You can write minus square root of 3 minus 2x plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem. Integration of sin square x dx. So given that integration of sin square x dx, so you can write integration of sin square x dx as 1 minus cos 2x by 2 into dx. So 1 by 2 into integration of 1 minus cos 2x dx. We separate the integration, 1 by 2 into integration of 1 dx minus integration of cos 2x dx plus c. So 1 by 2 into integration of 1 dx value x minus integration of cos 2x dx value is sine 2x by, here x coefficient is 2, so you can write by 2. So 1 by 2 into x minus sin 2x by 2 plus c. This is the solution of the given problem. Evaluate integration of cos square x dx, that is equals to integration of cos square x dx. You can write integration of cos square x dx as 1 plus cos 2x by 2 into dx. So 1 by 2 into integration of 1 plus cos 2x into dx. We separate the integration, 1 by 2 into integration of 1 dx plus integration of cos 2x dx. So 1 by 2 into integration of 1 dx value is x plus integration of cos 2x dx value minus plus integration of cos 2x dx value is sin 2x by, here x option is 2, so by 2 plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem. Problem, evaluate integration of square root of 1 minus cos x dx. The solution is integration of square root of 1 minus cos x dx. Integration of square root of, using submultiple angles, 1 minus cos x, you can write 2 sin square x by 2 into dx. So integration of, you can separate the root, we write root 2 into root of sin square of x by 2 into dx. Square and root cancel, so root 2 into integration of sin x by 2 dx. So root 2 into integration of sin x by 2 value is minus cos x by 2 by x coefficient is 1 by 2 into plus c. So root 2 into 1 by 1 by 2 value is 2, so minus 2 into root 2 cos x by 2 plus c. So this is the solution of the given problem.